This is Pat. In today's video, I am going to show you how to query an existing database using Entity Framework Core. Entity Framework allows interacting with a database using C# object instead of SQL. There are two approaches when working with Entity Framework: database first and code first. In the code first approach, you start by creating classes that describe the database, then Entity Framework generates a database based on your classes. In the database first approach, you start from an existing database, you generate classes from your database schema. This tutorial is about database first. Let's get into it. I am going to start by showing you the database that we are going to interact with. This database is located in my local SQL Express and is called AdventureWorks LT 2019. This is a database provided by Microsoft. It showcases the design of a database with SQL Server. It has a few tables. For simplicity, we will use only the product table. Let's create a console application in Visual Studio. I select the console application template. The project name will be EF Database First. I select the .NET 5 as the target framework. Once the project is generated, we will install the package needed to work with Entity Framework Core. Let's launch the Package Manager console. We start with the NuGet package for Entity Framework Core. The package name starts with Microsoft.EntityFrameworkCore. And the last segment of the package name identifies the provider. I use SQL Server, so the provider is SQL Server. Now we have to install Entity Framework Core tools for the NuGet Package Manager console in Visual Studio. This package will allow execution of commands on the database from the Package Manager. It is an alternative to the .NET Core command line interface. Both packages have been installed. Now we are going to generate entity models and the dbContext from the database. This process is also called reverse engineering. To achieve this goal, we will use the scaffold dbContext command. The first argument to the command is the connection string to the database. Let's specify the connection string. The next argument to the command is the provider name. This is the same as the provider's NuGet package name. Next, we need to specify which table is going to be involved in the reverse engineering process. By default, all tables are reverse engineered. I am going to specify the product table. The next argument will allow me to set a proper name for the dbContext. And lastly, I am going to specify the output folder for the generated files. Now I can execute that command. Let's see what has been generated. The first item is the dbContext. You can see that this class inherits from the dbContext. This is a requirement for Entity Framework Core. The dbContext will allow to query the database. The database connection string has been placed in the onConfiguring method. In a real-world scenario, you don't do this. You need to store your connection string in a safe place. Let's take a look at the product entity. This represents the product table. Let's make some operations on the database. I create a method named showProducts. I need an instance of the dbContext. I can use the property product, which is mapped to the table product in the database. The toList method will fetch all the data from the product table. We display only the product name and the product price. Let's call this method in the main method. If I run the project, you can see that I am able to fetch all the products. Now we are going to change the size of the first product in the table. Now the size is 58. We are going to change it. We need the product ID, which is 680. So I create a new method to update the product size. We are going to use an instance of the dbContext again. First, we are going to look for a product we need to modify. If we find that product in the database, we set the size to 60. We display a message stating that the product has been updated It's important to call the save changes on the dbContext. This will propagate change to the database. Let's call this method in the main method. Let's run the app. The message says that the product has been updated. Let's check into the database. The product size is still 58. Let's run the select method again. If I check now, the size has changed to 60. If you don't like using the command line, you can reverse engineer a database using a tool called efCore Power Tool. This is a Visual Studio extension. In order to demonstrate the usage, I am going to delete the DB folder. efCore Power Tool is already installed in my Visual Studio. Now, if I right-click on my project name, I can see the efCore Power Tool menu. I can select the reverse engineer item. I need to provide the connection string to my database. Because I have already tried the tool before, the connection string is already set. If I click on the OK button, I have another window that shows up. I can select which table I want to generate. In my case, I select the product table. In the next dialog, I can set the dbContext name. I can also set the path to the folder that will hold the entities. I set that path to DB. I also set the path for the database context to the same folder. I pluralize the generated object names to match the C# code conventions. In this case, for the product table, a product object will be created. I include the connection string in the generated code. If I click on the OK button, the tool will generate the object just like with the scaffold dbContext command. Let's show the product again to make sure the app is still working. As you can see, I'm still able to query the database. That's it for this tutorial. If you enjoy it, like the video and subscribe to the channel because it motivates me to make more videos. Thanks for watching. See you soon.